will be subjected to 160 kilonewton. Okay. Size is square section. Okay, 30 by 30. Length is 200 mm. You need to find out what is the Poisson's ratio. Poisson's ratio, right? I will take a 5 minutes time, you find out. Okay, what are the stress value we got here? What is the stress value you got?
One eighty, sir.
Right. Now sigma x equal to how much you got? 180. Right? Okay. You have a sigma y here, 0. Sigma z is 0. Right? Correct. Illala, available. Are you agree with this one? Are you agree with these three values? Sigma x is 180 megapascal, okay, it is acting only in x directions. There is no any stress in another directions. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Say yes or no. Okay. So next.
Yes, sir.
Is, okay. Next thing is calculate here using earlier relations. Okay. Using earlier relations. Now you are going to get the value of mu in these equations, because that will become unknown. That will become unknown. Example, if I want to find out here sigma mu 0 sigma y s, here mu sigma z. Okay. Now if you come to sigma y here, sigma y equal to what? Sigma y by e minus mu sigma x by e minus mu sigma z by e. Now these two becomes 0. Okay. What do you get? You are going to get mu into some value here. Similarly in z also, you are going to get mu into some value. Now if you add up here, sigma v equal to sigma ex plus sigma, okay, you are going to get this value in terms of mu. Okay, this value in terms of mu. Now change in volume is given. Volume is given, this is equal to E V. Okay. Is it right? Change in volume is given. They have given how much change in value? It is 64.8 mm³. Okay. Now divide by volume. It is volume is 330 into 30 into 200. You are going to get EV. Now equate this one with this value. Okay. You will get value of mu. you will get a value of mu. You take a 5 minutes, you clearly solve it. Now you need to upload today's solutions in a PDF file format to the WhatsApp group immediately after closing the class. Write your revision number on front sheet. Okay. Convert those into PDF file and upload it to WhatsApp group. Now you take a 5 minutes time and solve it. Bam. On the mission, good. Good. ಏನು ಮಾಡತ್ತೆ ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಯಾವ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಚ್ ಡಿಸೈನ ಮೈಸೂರಾಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಾರ್ಡನ್ ಹಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋನ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಹಲೋ ಹಲೋ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಗಾಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಹಿಯರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಫೋರ್ ಆರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಓಕೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ನೋಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ right you're not done it's 30 mm sorry it's 70 mm okay it's 70 mm long block as cross section of The block is subjected to force 60 kilonewton. It's of tension on 50 by 10 mm face, and hundred and 10 kilonewton compressive on 70 mm by 10 mm face. Full point. Determine the force to be applied on 70 mm by 50 mm face such that there is no change in volume. Take E equal to 200 gigapascal and mu equal to 0.3. Now you first draw the diagram. It's similar to the previous one, but in this case you need to go for a little reverse. Okay, you need to go for a little reverse. Now you need to find out what is the value of force that has to be applied over on a face, that is what, 70 by 50 mm. Okay. Now we will draw the diagram here. You can just note on the diagram. Okay, now just look out. 60 kilonewton on 50 by 10 mm face. Okay. Now this is what a tensile force of 60 kilonewton on this face. Okay. Now let us go for references here. You can go here X, Y, and Z. Now 110 kilonewton is compressive on face 70 into 10. Now 70 into 10 face is this one. Now it is of what compressive? Minus 110 kilonewton. Okay. Next, you need to find out to determine the force to be applied on 70 by 50 mm face. Okay. 70 mm by 50 mm face such that there is no any change in volume. There is no any change in volume. Okay. Got it? Now mu they have given. Young's modulus also they have given. Let us go for the stress which is going to act on this face. Let us go for it as an sigma z itself. Okay. Now you have again same equations. Okay, so now del EV equal to what? Okay. Now EV you are going to get a 0 here, you are going to get some equation, you are going to get some equation here. Okay. So now the equation what you are going to get for the value of EY, EX, EZ. So the stress is what unknown here. The stress is unknown. Sigma Z is unknown. So now you calculate unknown stress, find out unknown stress, sigma Z, considering volume as a 0. Volumetric strain as a 0. Okay. I think you got now. So try it. So now we calculate. If you got a stress, you can calculate a force. Is there anybody done? it's simple. Write equation for strain in x direction. Okay, so you are going to get a stress on that particular direction as the unknown. Then you sum up as you got earlier Poisson's ratio. Okay, in the similar way you are going to get the stress in z direction. Okay, once you got the stress, you can find out what is the stress, what is the load required to be on z direction. Keep sigma z as the unknown. Okay, so sum up, you are going to get some 0 on one side, you are going to get some value there. Okay, so in this case you have a two values, known values, sigma x and sigma y, is are known values. Only unknown value is sigma z. Okay. Okay. Now write equation for strains. Okay. Now we write equations for strains. minus okay. What is the equation you got? Final equation. Whether you got 120 plus sigma y minus 157. Here it is a minus 157 is a compressive stress. Go for a minus sign. Minus of minus, I think you are going to get a plus there. Simple, first write strain in x direction, okay, you are going to get unknown there, okay. What is the strain in x direction? Don't get too much complicated confusion, all solutions are simple here, you need to think about the writing the equation. Okay, right now I'll write the equation here, just cross verify here, okay. Now if you write equation here, okay, you are going to get some value, okay, plus some value here, minus, you are going to get this term in terms of z. Are you agree with this one? Are you agree with this one? Okay, now similarly come here, okay. So now this is what, sigma y divided by e minus mu sigma s by e minus mu sigma z by e, okay. Again you are going to get some value here, okay. Now based on sign convention you may get minus here, minus, so minus sigma z, again you have some value here, right. Next you add up sigma z, again you are going to get some value here. Now add these three equations, okay. You are going to get some value, minus or plus sigma z. Now this is what EV, now equate it to 0, equate it to 0, you are going to get a sigma z. So now this is what answer, okay. So answer is sigma y equal to minus 37 megapascal. Sigma y equal to minus, sorry, sigma z equal to minus 37 megapascal. Now what are the value you got? Sigma x equal to how much? 120 megapascal, it is the right answer, okay. And sigma y how much you got? Minus, okay, minus 157.1 megapascal, it is the right answer, okay. Condition they have given, delta V should be equal to 0, okay. Now EV equal to what? Delta V by V. Now this term will become a 0, is it right? Anything by 0 by anything is a 0, okay. Now you equate for the strain equations here. Okay, EX is epsilon X is in terms of Z, sigma Z. Epsilon y also in terms of z here, okay. Epsilon z is also in terms of sigma z. Now equate it, you are going to get minus 37 megapascal, okay. Now you neatly solve all these problems. Today I think you have 4 problems, okay. So solve them and upload to WhatsApp, okay, with PDF format. with PDF format. Okay. So I'll start next class the temperature stresses. We'll start next class temperature stresses. Okay. We'll provide attendance in chat box. Thank you.